Meanwhile, four taxi drivers operating in Koboko District and South Sudan's Juba town have been shot dead by armed forces along Yei Juba Road. The incident occurred at Ganji in Lanya County in South Sudan, about 46 miles from the capital, Juba City. We have the report.
The dead have been identified as Amati Stephen of Maracha District, Dada Gaddafi, Ali Noah, and Saddam Andama, all residents of Koboko Municipality in Koboko District. Koboko Municipality Mayor Dr. Sanya Wilson says that they are in touch with the South Sudanese authorities in Lanya County to have the bodies retrieved. So far, the killers have refused to hand over the bodies to the government. It is reported that an ambulance sent by the leadership of Lanya to pick the bodies this morning was forced to make a U-turn. The deputy DSO Koboko, Odong Geoffrey, revealed that many South Sudanese businessmen and women did not open up their shops, fearing revenge from the taxi drivers and the local community.
They are still at the scene. Those who laid the ambush have refused to give the bodies. Efforts to remove the bodies have been futile. The forces tried to rescue the body. We organized with the authorities of Lanya to go and pick the body. But the ambulance that we sent, as it was approaching the scene, the driver saw and gained another fire burning on that side. He decided to come back. So we are making efforts both from Yei to the scene and from Juba to the scene. If the team from Juba can secure the body, and then the body will come via Ilego. We will go as Ugandan authorities to pick it from Ilego border.
Odong held the affected families for containing their emotions at such a trying moment and advised them to use government offices appropriately to handle emerging issues. He also urged them to not engage in any revenge mission on South Sudan refugees. Meanwhile, the drivers furiously blamed the killing of Ugandans to the harsh treatment by the Uganda Revenue Authority.
They disturb us a lot. That's why these guys use this Soki Road, Yei Road. So I'm paying, this is the border district. Foreign numbers can enter Uganda, the one of Uganda can enter South Sudan. So we are appealing our government to help us. At least they have to look a way whereby we can't be disturbed.
They demand that the two governments of Uganda and South Sudan commit themselves to ensuring that the safety of the traders